Dear viewers and readers, I'm always happy to answer questions that you ask me. For example, in video number 134, I've reviewed my prayer habits and gave you an insight into the religious part of my everyday life. I hope that some valuable suggestions for your personal prayers were included. After that, there were a few requests regarding my daily work routine. Some of you may be writers themselves and are interested in how to write creatively, continuously, and in the longer term. So I'd like to give you some tips and report from my own experience. First of all, it's important that you clearly structure your day. This requires a certain amount of discipline. Of course, there will be times of leisure. Too long breaks are not beneficial to the flow of writing. Get up like me in the morning between 5:30 and 7 o'clock at the latest. It's not for nothing that it is said, the early bird catches the worm. Go to bed in the evening between 9 and 10 p.m. unless you are a real night person. Then other timing will apply to you. Don't strive against your biorhythm. Otherwise you are completely exhausted in the morning and can hardly collect yourself spiritually during the day. Important is the regularity which you keep day by day. This is not only beneficial for the health but also for the mental work. In my everyday life, prayer times, times of work and times of rest alternate. By the way, praying is also a good training for mental vitality and structured thinking. Organize the workplace in a way that you feel very comfortable in this environment. Creative thinking works best in a mode of heightened awareness under light tension in an absolutely calm environment. There are people who always need background noise when working. I personally don't belong to these. Don't eat too heavy at noon. Small portions of a main meal and a side salad are ideal. Drink regularly throughout the day. I always have a bottle of still water on my desk. This is especially true for the hot and sultry weather in the summer months. Take a break at noon for about 1 to 2 hours. Here is also a short nap possible, but do it only when you feel really tired. Between 2 and 3 p.m. I usually drink a cup of coffee. This will give me a boost for the rest of the afternoon. My finishing time is between 4 and 5 p.m. In particular, if you have worked highly concentrated, a little earlier closing time is useful and necessary. It's wrong to want to fight against one's weaker self at this point. Afterwards, this is avenged by headaches or burning eyes. Before you go to bed, you can read a good book or magazine or listen to an interesting program on the radio. Place a notebook and a pen by the bed so that you can clutch important thoughts that come to you in the evening before falling asleep. Especially the later evening often turns out to be a period of time in which the brain is highly active and the inspirations just sprout out. If you have noted everything carefully, you can end the day relaxed and thus have a restful sleep.